Hello, everybody! What's going on? This is Will here, and you are about to experience my last play session of Super Mario Sunshine for this official LP. That is right. This is Super Mario Sunshine, the official LP, as approved by Nintendo. Anyway, we're gonna start now. And if it's correct, I read online that you do get the last, you do get a sprite from, beating Chrono Mountain, so I'm assuming that that will be my 90th sprite, but I might be wrong. Anyway, whether that's right or wrong doesn't matter. All that matters is that we're about to go and confront Bowser. That's right. We're gonna confront him. We're going to confront the hell out of this guy. Let's do this. This will be our second time on this channel. We already did it once. Well, technically a third time if you take it. Well, actually, I shouldn't say that. Whoa, I found a blue coin somehow. Cool. How do I get over there? Can I not get over there from here? My bad. It's fine. Oh yeah, look at this. Jeez. Okay. Well, I'll just do it the old-fashioned way then. There we go. Anyway, there we go. Just jump in. And this is Chrono Mountain. We were in here for like a brief second a couple parts ago, but now we're actually going to do it. And this place is a pretty tricky spot. It's like a secret stage, pretty much. It's pretty much got the difficulty of one. It's not too bad. Well, the first part isn't too bad. I won't guarantee I'll survive. I might die like once or twice at this first part here. But that's only because I haven't practiced this place, and I haven't played this game in a couple years. Or, now I guess a year, maybe, about. Look at that! Hey, we've hit 100 blue coins! Look at that! That's crazy. It's awesome. Okay, gotta wait for that to drop back down. Now we just gotta... Ooh, jeez. There we go. The worst part about this is that when you're pushing forward, you have to push back so that you... position yourself over top of the flames so that you can douse them and put them out. It's... Oh, jeez. It's kind of stressful because, like, also the steam and the smoke comes up, so that can, like, obstruct your vision. So, anyway, there's another one up in here, I think. Yep, there it is. So I've got 8 lives now, that's good. And now, as you can see, oh geez, it looks like the frickin' lily pad level, huh? Well, it's kind of the same thing, except even more annoying. This is why I didn't do blue coin hunting, because of this one part here. Because it's freaking annoying. It really is. Look, I'm about to die. Look at this. Oh my god. Like, what you have to do is... Oh my god, dude. How do I do this? It's great. It's great. Okay. Do it like that. No. Oh my god. I'm about to die! I'm fine. Like the controls are horrible. Like, really, for, like, positioning this thing and stuff. Like, it's worse than the lily pad, and that's saying something. So really, you can't just, like, kind of speed your way through this. Which is kind of a pain. But it's necessary. There we go, okay. Okay. You don't have to worry much about your water supply either, unless you really suck at this. But even if you do, you know, like, there are little water fountains right there if we need them. Refill your water and stuff. Whoa, wait. Back up here. Hold the phone for a second. And as you can see, there are blue coins all along the, this middle island here. And that's- Oh, jeez. Oh, god, I'm dead. Yeah, like, see, like, that's- That's what annoys me. All you have to do is hit, just, like, bump one of those rocks and your boat goes down. And that's just, like, what really bugs me about this place. It's a really, really unforgiving section. Whereas with the lily pad, like, you can bounce off the sides and you can just kind of, like, go around all over the place. But with this boat, like, there's no forgiveness there. Like, you bump into something, you're dead. And the controls are even, like, more stiff than that. So, like, it just sucks. And I just died right there because I timed that poorly. Which is great, you know. I didn't really feel like... I didn't want to fight Bowser. Like, I didn't want this to be... Like, that time I forgot to equip my hover nozzle! Oh my god, Will, what are you doing? How have you made it this far? Oh my god, Will, what the hell are you doing? Get that equipped and just get over this. This is easy as hell. Come on. There you go. Okay, grab the one up. It's kind of hard to get game over in this area, despite how hard it is, just because of all the free lives they give you. So that's always good. As long as you can survive these little bits. So I guess if you're not used to relatively easy precision platforming with Flood, then, you know, you're not going to do well at this. Although I don't see why you wouldn't do well in this part here. This platforming is easier than, like, some of the platforming you do in, like, the secret levels. And apparently there are, like, cheap cheeps in the water, or whatever those are. I think those are cheap cheeps back there, like the little fish things that jump out. Those are fish, right? I just want to see. Yeah, they are. They're like cheap cheeps on fire. That's kind of frightening. But, like, I don't... I guess that's supposed to make it a little harder, but I don't think it does at all. I've never had a problem with those cheap cheeps before. Okay, I want to spray. Yeah, like, what the heck? Like, when you spray it, when you spray the water, the boat turns in the direction you spray. Like, when you're turning? That doesn't make a lot of sense for me. Like, look, I have to spray right. Look, what the heck? Now it's going... I'm so confused. Like, the controls, like, choose when they want to reverse. Here we go. Yeah, back up a bit. Like, look, I now I'm stuck, like... No, don't... Dude! Oh my god. Now I gotta get this thing turned around somehow. I guess like that. Alright. Good. Okay, now turn in this way a bit. Alright. Now we're just gonna go forward just a little bit. Okay, slow down. Jeez. Oh, God. Okay. Good. Oh, look at this. We're set up this time. Okay. Yeah, go forward a bit. There we go. And these are the blue coins that I really don't give two craps about. There are so many of them around here. Look at them all. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 8 blue coins that... surrounding this place, which is quite a few of them, really. I mean, that must be like a good like 3% of all of them. 3% of the 240 coins. That would be... Would that be 3%? Or... No, it wouldn't even. I don't know what percentage it would actually be, but whatever. Still quite a few. That's easy to map. Okay. This is another section that could be like potentially easy, but equally difficult. Because if you don't position your rocket jump very well and you start falling, like, uncontrollably in one direction, you can land right in the lava. So that's one thing to be aware of, although I couldn't see that being a very common issue. Anyway, we got another cutscene here. Oh, yeah, and Bowser's voice is laughably horrible. It's like when you hear like one of your friends like in school and they like start like tapping you on the shoulder and start telling you a story that some like big fat guys told. Like when they're trying to impersonate like one of those big fat guys, like that's what it's like. That's what it reminds me of. Anyway. Whoa. This is a pretty easy Bowser fight. Like there's nothing difficult here. Really. Nothing at all. And yeah, oh good, we lost some frames. That's the first time I've ever seen real frame loss in this game. I think that's a good thing. Well, not that there's frame loss, but that's the only time I've seen it so far. Well, no, if you're in first-person view, and you view underwater in first-person view, that causes some frames to be lost. I do remember that. Okay, Bowser, thank you. Oh wait, what am I doing? I can douse those, can't I? I can't douse the fire. Alright. Alright. Should I just take the hit? There, I took the hit. Not that it was that big of a deal. Alright. So weird how they, like, It's like almost reminds me of like the spring pads in Banjo-Kazooie, how like everywhere that you need to use like a powerful ground pound, they have like that symbol there. Like that weird like hockey puck thing. I don't know. Reminds me of a hockey puck, especially when it's on top of like the whatchamahoozit. You know, the whatchamahoozit. On top of the lighthouse. Delfino, yeah, Delfino Plaza. Okay, just barely made that. Almost fuffed that one up. Okay, jump over. There we go, we got this, we won. Incredibly easy and disappointing boss battle, but we did it anyway, look at that. Everyone's falling out of the giant bathtub full of whatever that stuff was, green jello, I guess. It's like that Sprite comic. Have you guys ever seen the Sprite comic in Sonic Nia? Oh my god. And like, there's like this one part where like Dr. Robotnik like frees Shadow. It's like a Sonic-based Sprite comic, and he's like, "Congratulations, Eggman. You may now wish for anything, and I'll grant it." And Eggman's just like, "I'd like a pool full of green jello." And he's like, "That's what you want. You want a pool full of green jello." He's like, "Yeah, yeah." He's like, "You don't want to wish for world domination or anything?" "No, I want the jello." guess what? I guess Eggman is really jealous of Bowser. And yes, as you can see right here, Mario. Oh no, Mario, I'm gonna die, Mario. Oh no! This was a sad time. Flood reminds me of Gamma and being one of those really likable and emotional robots. And that's a sad thing to have happen. So sad. But we've got another Shine Sprite. And it's at the Shine Gate now. That's right. Oh my god. And if you notice that buildup of music right there, the chords building up, that's actually the same chord buildup that's at the end of Super Mario 64 as well, which is kind of a cool little piece of trivia there. And look, everyone's all happy. Bowser Jr. and Bowser are out in the middle of the ocean, Team Rocket style.
Junior, I've got something difficult to tell you about Princess Peach.
I know, she's not really my mom.
Oh. Well then.
Someday, when I'm bigger... I wanna fight that Mario again.
That's my boy. Well put, son. The Royal Koopa line.
You know, he kind of sounds like Diabetes if he were to make an impression of Bowser. I bet Diabetes could do that impression perfectly. he's got that kind of voice. I don't know. Hey, hey. Oh, that song sounds familiar too. Why are you holding Flood? Oh my god. Oh my god, you repaired Flood! Mario, here's the credit sequence. Oh my god, look at that. Oh, look at that view. And anyway, that's the end of the LP, guys. This is the credit sequence for Super Mario Sunshine. And you get like a different like title card or something at the end of the credits if you get 100%, so it's like, it's not even worth doing, right? Like, who cares? I've shown you guys every level and like gotten like every secret, so like, you know, all I've missed is 100 coin stars and the blue coin hunting, so I've basically done the whole game. Oh yeah. Oh wow, Peach got a big one! Oh my god. Mario, you wanna go on those? They don't give you seatbelts, you know. There is an on-ride photo shoot on that thing? Oh, there's Peach and the Toads and... Oh, they're in frickin' Noki Bay! Why is Flood growing out of that green Toad's head? That's what I wanna know. Oh yeah. Yeah, we had to get some insightful character development for that yellow Toad. Oh, whatever. What was that splashed there? Is that Mario? Oh, yeah, look at that. Whoa, the Toads are in there, too. That's kind of cool. Oh, what a beautiful sunset. You actually get to see everything but the sunset. What's that sound? Is that supposed to be, like, the shore? Or, like, is my mic messing up? Oh, that's not my mic. That's the actual game. What the heck? Oh, look at that. That reminds me of the opening sequence for Big Story in Sonic Adventure DX. I saw that one picture, and I could feel, like, the theme song for Big, like, starting up in my head. Oh, no! Il Plantissimo found the magic brush! What's going to happen? Is that what's going to happen in Super Mario Sunshine 2? Is there a new game plus? No, there isn't. And that's it, guys. That's the end. I thought I was actually going to have to split that into two parts, but that was over pretty quickly. Wow. I did that perfectly in 15 minutes. Well, geez. I don't know then. Wow. I guess this is only 20. That's such an awkward length. Well, now, when I take into account the other levels I have to get 100 coins in, that's 6, actually. So by the time the bonus parts and these parts are put together, that'll actually be 35 parts, so that's actually a pretty good length. There we go, guys! That's Super Mario Sunshine! That's 75% of the Shine Sprites collected. I'll have a few more collected and stuff. And who knows, like, maybe if I ever do get around to doing, like, the blue coin hunting and 100% the game, I'll show that to you guys nice and quickly or something. But anyway, let's listen to this. I love it! See, this is what I was talking about. Like, that's so great! Oh yeah. My rumble was off the whole time too, I never noticed that. Turn the rumble on. My rumble was off the whole time! Did I do that manually, or did I do that by accident? Anyway. I'm standing over Mario B now, as to foreshadow me redoing this whole LP over again. I'm actually not redoing the whole LP over again. Oh man, you can't access files by ground pounding the blocks? That's dumb. Anyway, what I'm going to do, now that this LP's over, I'm not going to start a new LP right off the bat. I might wait, like, a couple weeks. Or, I don't know. I don't know yet. Like, I don't know if I want to put another LP in this block. Not that I'm gonna, you know, like, stop LPing or anything. But I think I just want to, like, dumb it down to, like, two LPs, just so that I have more time to invest in both of them, rather than having three and kind of having to spread out interests. At least, if it's two, I can say, like, okay, I want to invest in this one or this one. So that it's not, like, there's, like, gonna be a third place. I don't know. I just find two's easier to work with than three, but I don't know. And then four is just too many. Four is an even number, which is nice, but then it's just too many LPs. No, I don't want to access that one. Woo! Anyway. Whatever. I hope you guys, really enjoyed this LP. I may as well, start this again. You need to 100% the game to get the second upgrade from the sunglasses guy, right? You need 100%. Like, that's what I was thinking. I would do another video for when I actually got 100%, so I could show that off. I'm pretty sure you need all the sprites. Oh, no, you do get them. Okay, so this is another upgrade you get once you beat the game, I guess. This guy says, hey, sunshades alone won't cut it for you. Nope. You also need one of my custom tropical shirts. Here you go. Look at that. Look at that. Mario is dressed for summer. That is... Oh, Mario, you are one sexy beast, Mario. Oh, look at you. It's sexy. Alright, Mario, you just sit on a bench. You can be the new Forrest Gump. Just sit on the bench and offer people chocolate. That's all you gotta do. There you go. Now he's sort of sitting. I'll make it so that he's sitting. I don't know how I'll do this. It's easier with, like, 2D, like, old 8-bit games when it's easy to, like, use your imagination. Okay, that's about as good as I can do. It sort of looks like he's sitting. I don't know. Anyway, I'm having too much fun with this. I'm at 19 minutes now, so I may as well just, I'll end the part here, I guess. Look how dark the whole screen is with these sunglasses on. It's weird. Anyway, that's it for the LP. I'm gonna grab your bananas and run with them. Peach, start the boat! Start the boat, I got bananas! Anyway, I hope you all have a very good life. I hope you all had a lot of fun. I hope those words just kind of like mixed together. I hope you all had a lot of fun watching this LP, because I had a lot of fun playing through this game again. This game's pretty special to me. This game took up a lot of my childhood. Not near as much as some other games, but like, for the amount of time I had it, I played it quite a bit. So I'm glad I was able to play this game and to share my thoughts with you guys. And I hope I can just continue to share more my thoughts and memories with you guys in future LPs. So, this has been Will, your host of this LP, and I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife if you're Pink Yoshi about to die in the water, looking to kill me in the next episode. Aw, you're dead, Yoshi. You're about to fall. Oh, you disintegrated into nothing. Looks like Mega Man lost a life. Okay. That was even stupider. Peace.